term digital arrest is not a recognized legal term. It is typically used to describe instances where individuals are threatened or coerced into paying money or complying with demands under the guise of legal action or arrest. These scams are often carried out online using forged documents or impersonations of government officials. Welcome to VAR India News Hour. A disturbing trend has emerged in India, with cyber criminals targeting victims across the country using fake arrest warrants and official documents from agencies like the RBI and CBI. These fraudulent notices accuse individuals of money laundering and other crimes in an attempt to extort money. Authorities are urging the public to be aware of this scam and take steps to protect themselves. While there is no official data on the specific number of digital arrest cases, it is widely believed that they are increasing in frequency due to the growing number of people using the internet and the sophistication of cybercrime techniques. In the year 2024, the term digital arrests has been increasingly associated with scammers, using it as a tactic to deceive people in cyber frauds and phone scams. Cyber criminals impersonating as police officials, CBI officials, or other authoritative figures over phone and video calls have been tricking individuals into believing they are under investigation or involved in a legal issue. This manipulation often leads to victims handing over large sums of money in fear of being arrested or prosecuted. Scammers are increasingly using well-crafted fake documents that exploit legal language to create a sense of fear and urgency among their victims. These fraudulent documents are designed to appear official and legitimate, often incorporating references to specific sections of the Indian Penal Code to bolster their credibility. In response to the increasing prevalence of digital arrest scams in India, government agencies and law enforcement agencies are stepping up their efforts to crack down on these fraudulent operations. Authorities are urging individuals who receive suspicious communications claiming to be from agencies like the RBI or CBI to report them immediately. By staying vigilant and reporting suspicious communications, individuals can help prevent the spread of these scams and bring the perpetrators to justice. Let's look into today's headline. Google to announce notification sync across Android devices. Google is working on a function that will remove duplicate notifications across various Android devices. This development stems from the most recent Android 15 Beta 2 release, which hints at a sync across devices feature that would allow alerts to be marked as read on and all devices at the same time. Android users currently endure the annoyance of viewing the same notice on multiple devices after interacting with it on one. IBM expands its FinOps portfolio with acquisition of KubeCost. IBM has acquired KubeCost, a leading FinOps startup specializing in Kubernetes cost management. This follows the company's significant investments in the FinOps space, including the $4.3 billion acquisition of Apptio in 2023. KubeCost's focus on efficiency aligns well with IBM's broader strategy to provide comprehensive IT and FinOps solutions to enterprises. The acquisition of KubeCost is expected to strengthen IBM's FinOps suite, combining capabilities of Cloudability and Turbonomic. BlackRock, Microsoft team up to raise $30 billion for AI investments. BlackRock, Inc. and Microsoft Corporation are joining hands on one of the largest efforts to date to bankroll the build-out of data warehouses and energy infrastructure behind the boom in artificial intelligence. The companies, along with the United Arab Emirates MGX investment vehicle, will seek $30 billion of private equity capital over time for the strategy. The idea is to leverage the money to as much as $100 billion in potential investment. Samir Kumar to replace Manish Tiwari as head of India operations for Amazon. Amazon has elevated Samir Kumar as the country manager for India. The e-commerce major said in a note that this is an additional responsibility to Kumar, who will continue to lead Amazon's consumer businesses in the Middle East, South Africa and Turkey. The move comes after Manish Tiwari abruptly resigned as the country head of India on August 6. Tiwari, who has been at the helm of India operations since July 2020, is moving on after spending over 8 years at the company. Snapchat unveils new AI features. As part of its new AI features, Snapchat users will now be able to toggle between their personal and public accounts, depending on whether they want their profiles to be visible to just their approved friends or a wider audience. The new and simplified profile design aims to simplify the Snapchatter experience by organizing the app around what we use our phones for most: communications, taking pictures, and entertainment. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to VAR India Magazine. You can download the VAR India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for more news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.